Today, I'm going to show you how to use Photoshop's AI Germ to Fill with After Effects, a game changer for crafting dynamic environments. By the end of this video, you'll be able to turn your videos into cinematic masterpieces. Hi and welcome. If you're new to my channel, my name is Martin and I love creating engaging video content. In today's video, we're going to take a closer look into Photoshop's AI Generative Fill in combination with After Effects. If you don't know how to track your footage in After Effects, make sure to check out my previous video on motion tracking. I'll leave a link to it in the description down below and you can also download the footage to follow along this video. Let's get started. When you upload your first clip into After Effects, you can take the clip and drag it down here to this icon to create a composition. So with this first clip, I'm gonna go through some of the basics of Generative Fill. So the plan is to add some elements maybe down here in the bottom and also on top here without crossing over the path where I'm walking here in the middle. The first thing we're gonna do is to find like a suitable frame. So I'm just gonna pick some random one here in the middle, go up here and make sure that the resolution is set to full, then go up to composition, save frame as, and Photoshop layers. Save it somewhere where you can find it and click save. After you saved it, we can open it up in Photoshop. All right, so now we open the image inside Photoshop. The first thing you wanna do is click on select subject. Now selected the subject, we can go up to select, modify, and expand. Expand it by at least 30 pixels and press okay. Now we can see that this Generative Fill box appears. Click on it and leave this field empty and click generate. This should remove the subject from the image and creating a clean plate. Cool. Next, we want to add some elements into the scene and we can do this in two ways. We can either use the marquee tool up here on the left or we can use the lasso tool to make a selection. I'm going to use the marquee tool here and make a selection down here in the corner. After you made your selection, click on generate fill and type in anything that you want to generate in this area. This should give us three options that we can choose from. And we can just scroll through them here by clicking on the arrow. If we don't like any of these, we can just press generate again until we find something we like. Next up, we want to add a moon up here in this area here. So I'm going to go up to the marquee tool again and right click it and select the elliptical marquee tool instead. Now try to make a selection in the general area that you want to kind of create a moon. So I'm going to try to select this area here and we can type in moon. And let's do the same over here on the right top corner. Try to make the selection a little bit bigger this time. All right, so when you're done inside Photoshop, you can just press Command S to save the project. So now we're back inside After Effects. We can now import the Photoshop file into the project. And I'm just gonna simply drag it over here. Now we get this prompt, make sure that the import kind is set to composition, retain layer sizes, and edit for layer styles is fine. Press OK, and now we get a composition for all the layers, and then we get all the clips separate down here. All right, so if we double click into this composition, we can see we have all the layers that we added inside Photoshop right here. The bottom one here, that's called clip one, is actually the screenshot that we took before. So if we disable this by clicking this eye, we can see we have the three elements that we created inside Photoshop with Generative Fill. So let's take these three top layers and press Command C on the keyboard to copy them. And then go back here to the first composition. Go to the beginning of the clip and press Command V to copy them in. So now as you can see, we have all the three elements inside our scene. And since there's no camera movement, it actually already kind of works. We do see a little bit of an edge around our selection here. Also, if we hide the background, we can see this edge around here is visible on this shot here. So what we can do about this is we can just create a mask around it and put a little bit of feathering on. So let's select the moon here. I'll go up here and change it into a elliptical tool. Try to make a selection within the moon here. I'll just zoom in a little bit. And just make sure that it kind of covers just around the moon's edges, just like this. And then we can go down here on the mask and add a little bit of feather. And we'll do the same with the other moon. All right, so now that I'm done, we can see that now we don't have that itch anymore on either of the elements. And this clip is already working. Now, the last thing I want to do is just to right click down here and press new and then add a adjustment layer. Go up here to effects on the right side and search on Lumetri color. I'm just going to add a curve and a little bit of color grade to blend the images better. All right, let's move on to a slightly more advanced clip. All right, so here we are inside After Effects with a second clip. I already created the composition, and if I scroll through the footage here, we can see that here we have significantly more camera movements. So this would be a little bit more tricky, but the procedure is basically the same until we get into the After Effects portion. So because we have a clip now with camera movements, we actually need to take note of where we take the frame from. So when you found the spot that you want to put into Photoshop, hold Control down on your keyboard and press 8. This should create a marker on the clip, which is exactly where we're gonna take the frame from. So just like before, we make sure that the resolution is set to full. We go up to Composition, Save Frame As, and Photoshop Layers. After we save the frame, we can open it up in Photoshop. So here we are inside Photoshop, and we're just gonna do exactly the same as before. Select Subject, go to Select, Modify, and Expand. 30 pixels, Generate to Fill, and Generate. So the first thing I want to add is I kind of want to add a building right here. I want to add a moon again and probably some kind of tower here. So let's start with the building here. I'm going to use the rectangular marquee tool and I'm going to just try to select this area and include a little bit of the sand in the bottom. Press G to fill and then you can type in whatever you want to generate. Also, if you create something like this but you don't like the top part, you can actually just select this. Leave the generate to fill blank and just press generate. You can also select the area here and add something on top if you feel like this looks too flat. After you've created something you like, you can just select all three layers and right click it and press merge layers. That way it makes it easier to edit when we put it back into After Effects. When you've done all the changes that you want to do, we can go ahead and save it and go back to After Effects. Alright, so now we're back into After Effects and we're just gonna open up the Photoshop file. Make sure that Import Kind again is set to Composition Retain Layer Sizes. Edited Layerable Styles is fine. Press OK. Alright, so just like before, it created this composition with all the layers and the layers separate down here. We're just gonna go inside the composition here and check how it looks. And we can see we have all the layers here. Again, the bottom one, we don't need this one, so I'm just gonna disable it. And here we can actually see the layers that we created. So I'm just going to go ahead and select these, copy them over, Command C to copy, and then go back in here and go to the beginning of the clip and press Command V to copy them in. But already now you can see that the elements doesn't line up, and that's because we need to track the footage. But if you go to the marker that we created earlier, you can see that on the marker it actually lines up. So let's take one item at a time. These two kind of goes together, so let's just disable the two other ones. So first, let's start by tracking this building into the shot. Click on your clip, go over here on the right side and click on Tracker. If you don't see it, go up to Windows and click on the tracker right here. Motion Source, make sure that it's set to the clip. Click on Track Motion and a tracker should appear here. Make it a little bit bigger and let's go over here close to where the tower is gonna be and let's try to see if we can track something here. So since the tower is going to be in this area here, I think we can use this tracking point here. Ideally, you want to find a place that has like high contrast within the feature area here. And then you also have the search area here, which you can make a little bit smaller if you want. The bigger it is, the longer it's going to take to track. I'm going to also check mark the rotation here, which is going to give us another tracker. And for this tracker here, let's put it on this person here and also scale this up a little bit. So it's a little bit easier to see. Go over to Options, make sure that this one is set to stop tracking at least 80%. And now we can zoom a little bit out. Let's make this a little bit smaller. And then let's just go ahead and press Analyze Forward. All right, that seemed to work pretty well. Let's go back to the marker and now we're gonna analyze backwards. All right, cool. That seems to work pretty well. If we scrub through here, we can see that the trackers are actually on the point all the way through. Now we can go down here and right click, go to new and create a null object. Come back here to the tracker panel, go to Edit Target, make sure that the layer is set to Null 1, press OK, and then press Apply. Apply Dimension XY, press OK. So now we applied all the tracking points onto the null object. Back to the mark, go to the building that we want to track to the data, which is these two layers. Go to Parent Link and set it to Null 1. If you don't see the parent and link, you can press the toggle switches down here. And if you don't see those, you can right click here, go to column and go to parent and link. Now when we scroll through, we can see that the footage is actually tracked onto the tracker data and actually follows the shot pretty well. Now we can do the same for the two other objects that we haven't tracked in yet, which is the moon and this tower here. And just like before, we're gonna start on the marker point and let's hide the tower for now. So with the moon here, we can see we don't have any clear contrast points. So what I'm going to try to do is actually I'm going to try to track the clouds right beneath it. Because since the moon is so far back in the distance, I think we can get away with it without seeing any major parallax issues. So let's try go for that. Just like before, we're going to select the original clip, go to track motion, and now it's going to create a tracker, which is now called tracker 2. And let's try to zoom in here and make this a little bit bigger. Let's see if we can find any point here that could work, maybe around here. Press the rotation and we'll get another tracker. Let's size that up a bit and try to find another point maybe here. And let's just see how that goes. I'm just gonna go ahead and track forward. Now go back to our marker and analyze backwards. So let's go down here again, right click, press new and null object. Now we can go back to the tracker panel again, click Edit Target, and this time make sure it's set to Null 2. Press OK, Apply, XY, OK. And now we should have the data for the second tracker here. And just like before, we're going to go to the marker, and now we can put the parent and link to the Null 2. Let's have a look. And as you can see here, this also works quite well. All right, so the only thing we're left to do now is to track the tower. All right, and now if you play it through, it looks like this. The last thing to do is to add some color grade. All right, so for the third and the last clip, we have this shot here where the camera is moving up like this. And I thought it could be cool to replace this whole area here where we have an opening in the sky. But as you can see, when the camera comes up here, we actually have the subject overlapping that. But there's a way to fix this. I'm gonna speed up the first part with Generative Fill so we can get straight into how we can mask out the subject. So make sure to stay until the end. All right, so after we're done, we can go into the composition again. And here we can see the different layers that we worked on. So if we hide the bottom layer here, we can see the different layers that I created. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy these into the main composition, like so. And just like before, I'm just gonna track each element one by one. And I'm gonna speed this part up again. Cool, so now I tracked all the elements, and if I scroll through here, we can see it looks pretty cool, except for one thing here, which is that part of this generative fill is going in front of the subject. And in order to fix this, we just need to copy this clip down here and rotoscope it. So I'm gonna press Command D on the keyboard and move this clip up on the top of the composition. Now double click onto the top clip to get into the layer. And now we click on this small icon here, which is the rotor brush tool. If the rotor brush tool is too small, you can hold Command down on your keyboard and left click on your mouse and drag it to either left or right to increase or decrease the size of the brush. And then we're just gonna move to a frame where we can see a little bit more detail. So around here where we see the backpack. So I'm just gonna start painting in here and see how it looks. So. And already off the bat, you can see it worked pretty well. We just needed to cover like this area here in the center. So now we just press freeze and wait for the rotor brush to finish. Now that it's done, we can minimize this one and go back to the main composition. And now we can actually see that when we scroll through here, that the gentle fill layer is actually behind the subject and we have the subject in the foreground. We can unhide this here to see where the layer was actually overlapping. And finally, we're just gonna add a color grade to make it blend better. So that's how you can use this to create these crazy environments for your scenes. I hope this video was helpful. As always, feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Stay tuned for more content like this and let me know what you would like to learn next time on this channel. See you next time.